Hello and welcome to this Swift and Xcode tutorial. Today we're going to be continuing on with our calendar view. In previous tutorials we built a monthly and a weekly calendar view. Today we're going to be building a daily calendar view. This daily calendar view is going to obviously work in with all of our monthly and our weekly, and instead of scrolling through the weeks we're just going to scroll through one day at a time. Our daily calendar view is going to show a list of events by hour, so and even if there's no events we're just going to show 24 hour time 0 to 23. Also by popular request I'm going to show you guys how you can add the last few days of the previous month as well as the starting few days of the next month grayed out on our monthly calendar view, so stick around for that at the end. So picking back up from where we left off last time, I'm going to clone the calendar example tutorial from GitHub and then just choosing the branch as our weekly calendar, changing the folder to calendar example tutorial daily. And firstly, we're going to head into the main storyboard. We're going to drag in an extra view controller. This is going to be for our daily calendar view. And then we're going to drag a button onto our weekly calendar and just renaming this to daily. Readjust all of these view controllers so they fit a little bit nicer, and then we're just going to right click from our button onto our new view controller and just selecting show as our segue. Now we can change the title to daily calendar, and then we're going to head to our weekly calendar. We're going to select the two buttons as well as the month text and just copy and paste them into our daily calendar. Update those constraints to the new view controller, so we're just going to right click from our label and say center horizontally as well as top space to the safe area, and then we're going to head in and modify those constraints. Align top, we're going to give it 20, and then from our button we're just going to give our left one leading space and our right one trailing space. Then we can head into our side pane and set those both to 0. Cool, and then we're just going to grab one of our day of weeks and just say vertical spacing and center horizontally off our label. We're going to give it top space to that 20 SP, and then we're going to give it the full Thursday, so that's what it's going to look like. And then we're going to drag in a table view. We're going to give our table view some constraints, so bottom, leading, and trailing space to the safe area, as well as top space to our Thursday label. And we're going to modify that constraint to be 20, and the ones to the safe area we're going to set to 0. Now we can add in a table view cell. We're going to adjust the height to be 70. And then we're going to drag in a label, and this is going to store the time. For its constraints, we're just going to give it leading space as well as top space, and adjusting them to be 10 and 5. And we're going to make this text size a little bit bigger, as well as just some placeholder, so say 10 o'clock. And then we're going to drag in a view. We're going to change the background color to this light gray color, and we're going to give it trailing space to the container, as well as top space and bottom space. And then we're going to give it some horizontal spacing to our time label. The time label spacing we're going to set to 10, but the other three we're going to set to 0. And then inside our view, we're going to drag in a label. We're just going to give it leading space, center horizontally, and equal width. But I'm going to change this to 0.3 and the leading space to 10. And then we just need to give our time label a fixed width. So we're just going to give it, say, 80. And then we're going to head in and align our text for our time label to be aligned in the middle. And then our label is not liking something. So I'll just quickly check that it needs a constraint for its Y position. So I'm just going to say center vertically in the container and set its alignment to the center as well. We're going to give it max lines of 2, as well as one more constraint. We're going to say equal heights to its parent view, and then we're going to go in and modify that to be 0.8, so 80% of the height. We're going to change the background color to this teal color, text color to white, and I'm just going to rename the placeholder text to event 1. And then we're going to copy and paste that next to and just give it horizontal spacing as well as center vertically. We're going to give it equal heights and equal widths, and then hit update our view. And we're going to do that one more time. So we're going to have three events, sort of squares, same constraints for our third one, but to our second event. So that's starting to look pretty good. What we're going to do next is say command N to create a new Swift file. And I'm just going to name this file our daily cell. And I'm going to hit command N again, create another Swift file, calling it daily view controller. And for our daily cell, we're just going to go in and copy the class from our event cell and paste that in. So we're importing the UIKit as well. And then just changing the class name to daily cell. For our daily view controller, we're going to do a similar thing with our weekly view controller. We're going to copy and paste the class definition as well as importing the UIKit. We're going to remove the collection view stuff because we're not going to have a collection view in our daily view controller. However, we do have a table view, so we're going to click on that error message and add the protocol stubs. And you can see that's added our two table view protocol stubs. And then we just need to change our class name to our daily view controller. Now we can head back into our main storyboard. We're going to apply our table view cell, the class of our daily cell. And the same thing for our view controller. We're going to set its class to be daily view controller. Then we're going to right click and drag from our table view and just assign our view controller to be our table view data source as well as our table view delegate. Cool. So I think we're ready to create some outlets. So I'm just going to open up the assistant editor. I'm going to hide this left pane here. And we're going to right click and drag from our label. I'm just going to call this day label. I'm going to create some actions for our buttons. So the first one being next day action, and the previous one being our previous day action. And you can see I've put in a typo there. So to fix this, we're just going to right click on the button, remove that connection, fix our typo, and then drag the connection again. From our Thursday label, we're going to call this day of week label. We're going to create an outlet for our table view, just calling it our table view. And for whatever reason, The assistant editor isn't showing our cell. I'm going to close it off, create a second window by hitting this button in the top right hand corner. I'm going to select on our daily cell, right click and drag from our time label and just naming this time. And then we just need to create an outlet for each of our events. So the first one I'm calling event one, event two, and event three. Now we can close off that second view. Just before we finish up with our layout stuff, we're going to drag in one more button onto our daily view and link it up so that we can create a new event from our daily calendar view. So I'm just going to change the system item to this add, just zoom out a little bit, and then right click and drag onto our edit event, selecting action segue as show. Cool, so let's head into our dailyviewcontroller.swift file. And first thing we're going to do is just create a variable calling it hours, which is an integer array. We're going to override the viewDidLoad function and just calling superViewDidLoad. And we want to create a function just calling an initTime. This function is just going to populate our hours array with all the hours of the day. So just saying for hour in 0 to 23, hours append hour. And below that, we're going to create another function. We're going to call it setDayView. We're going to call that from our viewDidLoad. And here we're just going to say daylabel.text, and we need to go into our calendar helper and just create a month day string. So we just need to copy down our month string function and just renaming it to month day string and then changing the formatter to include days. Then I'm going to scroll down because we also want a day of week function to return either Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. So we're just going to say weekday as string, and it's going to return a string. And then we're going to call our weekday function, giving it the date that's passed through. And if the case is zero, we're going to return Sunday. The default, we're just going to return nothing. And then we're going to copy and paste down and just change it to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And then just updating the case of the switch to be the correct day of week for the correct string. And then in our set day view, we can say day label.text is equal to our calendar helper month day string that we just created and passing it through our selected date. And then we're going to do the same thing for the day of week label, just calling calendar helper and giving it the function we just created, so the weekday as string and giving it our selected date. And even though we haven't done our hours table view stuff, we're just going to call our table view reload data. For our next day function, we're actually just going to go in and copy and paste that from our week view controller and just changing that to days one. And instead of calling set week view, we obviously need to call set day view. And then we're going to copy and paste that into our previous day action and just giving the days minus one. A number of rows in section table view function, we're just going to return the hours count. And for our self row and index path, we're going to steal what we've done in our weekly view controller. We're going to change the identifier to cell daily ID and then copy and paste that, head into the main storyboard. We're going to apply that identifier to our daily cell, and our cell is no longer a type event cell, it's a daily cell. So we're just going to change that to daily cell. We're going to remove the next two lines of code and then just say let hour equal to our hours index path row. So getting the hour from our index path.row. And then we're going to create a function calling it format hour, which receives an hour and returns a string. Inside here, we're going to return string with the format of %02d and then a little time dots and then %02d and then just passing it in our hour and zero. And we're going to say cell time is equal to our format hour, giving it our hour. And we just need to say cell time.text. Cool. And we also need to set our events if there are any for that hour. So what we're going to do is create a function calling it set events, which receives our daily cell as well as a list of events. So to get our list of events, we're going to head into our event swift file, copy and paste down this events for date, because we also want an events for date and time. And that's going to receive a date as well as an hour. And before we check our time, we actually need to head into our calendar helper and create a function which gets the hour from a date. So I'm just going to copy down our day of month function, renaming it to hour from date, and then we just need to change the date component to an hour as well as components and giving it hour. So now we can head back into our event, and inside our if statement we're going to say let event hour is equal to our calendar helper hour from date and giving it our event date. And then we can say if our event hour is equal to the hour that's passed in, then we can append our event to our day's event. Now heading back to where this all started, our day view controller, we can just say let events equal to our event events for date and time. Our date, we're going to give it selected date, and our hour is our hour. And now we can call our set events, giving it our cell as well as our events list. So below our set events, we're going to create a function calling it hide all, which receives our daily cell. And we're just going to say cell event one is hidden is equal to true. And the same thing for event two and three. And that's the first thing we're going to call in our set events. Then we're going to create a switch calling events count. And if there's one event, we just want to set event one. And we're going to pass it through a cell as well as the event at position zero. So the first event in the list. We're going to create a function calling it set event one, which also receives our daily cell as well as the event. And we're just going to say cell event one is hidden is equal to false. cell event one text is equal to our event name. And then we're going to copy and paste that function down and just changing the names to set event two and set event three and just changing the event to the correct event. And now we can copy down our case and we're just going to say if there's two, we want to set two events. And if there's three, we want to set three events. And then we're going to create one more case, which is if there's more than three events. So we're going to say case let count where count is greater than three. We want to set event one and two with just the first events. But then we're also going to create one more function, which we're going to call set more events. And that's going to receive the count of how many more events there are. Event three, we're going to set the text value of our count, more events. And then we're just going to call that and passing it in the cell, as well as the events count minus two. And we're going to head back into the main storyboard and fix a few little bugs or errors that I made. So this segue, I selected off the wrong button. So it was off the button item and not the actual button. So I'm just going to click on that button and then create that show action segue. And then our table view row height is actually done through the table view and not the cell, turning it off automatic and setting it to 70. And then we're going to head into our daily view controller and we're just going to override the view did appear, just calling super view did appear and passing it through animated. And then we're just going to set our day view. Something I should have done in previous tutorials. So I'm just going to fix that up in our weekly view controller. We're just going to call set week view and then copy and paste and put that into our view controller for our month view and just call set month view. Cool. So I think we're finally ready to build and run this. We're just going to click on the weekly and then the daily. We can move through the days and the day of the week seems to be updating correctly and we're moving through one day at a time. We can scroll up and down our time table view as well as add some events directly from our daily calendar view. Let's add a couple of events just to see if when we get three events in one place, it's all working correctly. Cool, so that was a daily calendar view. What we're gonna do next is just modify our monthly calendar view to show previous and next month's days grayed out. Cool, so firstly, we're gonna create a new Swift file calling it calendar day. We're just gonna initialize the class name as calendar day, and it's gonna have a variable called day, which is type string, and an enum of month. So our month, we're gonna have a previous month, a current month, and a next month. And then we're gonna create a variable calling it month, which is of our type month enum. And now back into our view controller, we're going to change our total squares to be our calendar day instead of a string. And that's going to give us some error messages. So we're going to say let calendar day is equal to a new calendar day. And then we're going to take our total squares append. And instead of appending a string, we're going to append that calendar day that we just created. Next, we're going to split out our or statement. So instead of being an or, we're going to turn it into an else if statement. So for our current month, we're going to say calendar day is equal to what we've been appending in our total squares. And then we're just going to say calendar day month is equal to our calendar day month current. Then right at the top, we're going to create a variable calling it previous month, which is equal to our calendar helper minus month, giving it selected date. So we get the month before. And then we're going to find out how many days were in the previous month by calling our days in month function and giving it our previous month. Now that we know how many days are in the previous month, we can say let previous month date equal to days in previous month minus starting spaces plus count. And then that's what we can give our calendar day if it's a previous month. And then we're just going to set our month to be month previous. We're going to paste that down into our next month as well and just calling it next. For our next month day, it's pretty easy. We're just going to say calendar day is equal to the string value of count minus days in month minus starting spaces. Cool. And now we can head down and change our cell. So we're just going to say let calendar day equal to total squares at indexPath.row. And then we're going to change our day of month text to be our calendar day. And then we're going to create an if statement just saying if our calendar month day is equal to our current month, we want to set our cell day of month text color to be black. Otherwise, we want it to set it to be gray. So I'm just going to copy and paste down that line and just changing it to UI color gray. Cool. And if we build and run this again, we can see that the previous month days as well as the next month days are grayed out. So there you go. That was a daily calendar view as well as some adjustments to our monthly calendar view. If you liked the video, give it a like. Otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next one.